And a short word about my programming equipment. This is the programmer which you can buy from AliExpress for as little as $2, sometimes even less. This one uses CH341a chip, which is really good, and this one is modded. You see this sticker. This one is modded to supply 3 volts no matter what, because unmodded version, despite that you set it to supply 3 volt, not the regular 5, it still brings 5 volt to the data line. It only changes the VCC, which is, it's fine, we don't use it anyway, but it keeps 5 volt on data lines. We modded to work on 3 volt, no question. The mod is really easy. A child can do that. Look at this. You connect this leg to this capacitor. Then you cut this trace and you add a jumper. Jumper which sets 3 volt to 5 volt. This one. And we supply 3 volt back through 5 volt to the chip and make it work at 3 volt. Really easy. I also 3D printed this bracket just to protect the programmer, because when you use it a lot, and I use this quite a lot, it makes this connector really flimsy and sometimes it breaks, so I use this bracket. And then I have this little socket for unsoldered flash chips. So I don't need anything. I don't need to solder the chip. I just use this socket to program it right on the programmer. And also this 3D printed bracket is used as a leg, so it stays flat on the surface. I color-coded my programmer. I color-code a lot just because it saves time. It's easier. And I also have this clip adapter where I cut the leg 8. Leg 8, as you can see, it's leg 8. It's marked with red here that there's no leg 8. There's no leg 8. I cut it off because this is VCC. This is VCC, and we do not connect power to the chip. It takes power from other auxiliary legs, but it still works. That's magic of a snander. That's why I use it. And this is how you reliably read and write your flash chip with this little programmer.